To get started with our worship and to celebrate Mother's Day for all you mothers out there, we ask the blessing of the Lord be upon you, and may your children rise up and call you blessed. Amen?
Amen.
Yeah, let's worship Jesus. We have a vision for this nation. We have a dream for this land. We join with angels in celebration. By faith we speak revival in this land. That's what we need, amen. We have a vision.
We have a vision for this nation. We have a dream for this land. We join with angels celebration. By faith we speak revival in this land, where every knee shall bow and worship you, and every tongue confess that you are Lord. Give us an open heaven, anoint our prayers this day, and move your song for this nation. We share a dream for this land. We join with angels in celebration. By faith we speak revival in this land, where every knee shall bow and worship you, this nation,
where every knee
shall bow and worship you, and every tongue confess that you are Lord. Oh, give us an open heaven, anoint our prayers this day, and move your sovereign hand across this nation. Worship you, and every tongue confess that you are Lord. Give us an open heaven, anoint our prayers this day, and move your sovereign hand across this nation.
Give us
an open heaven, anoint our prayers this day, and move your sovereign hand across this nation.
Give us an open heaven, anoint our prayers this day,
and move your sovereign hand across this nation.
And move, Lord. Oh, move your sovereign hand across this nation.
And move your sovereign hand across this nation.
Yes, Lord, move your sovereign hand, God. Who can resist the Lord? Who can resist the sovereignty? For he rules and reigns. Jesus, we thank you that this truly is a nation founded on your word and on the truth. We thank you, Lord, that you have given us an open heaven. So we come to seek you, to pray, to call upon your name, Lord. We will seek your face, Almighty God.
We will seek your face, my God. Turn and pray for you to heal our land. Father, let revival start in us. Then every heart will know your kingdom come.
Let's sing that again. We will seek your face.
We will seek your face, Almighty God. Turn and pray for you to heal our land. Father, let revival start in us. And every heart will know your kingdom come.
Lifting up the name of the Lord,
in power and in unity,
we will see the nations turn, touching heaven, changing earth, touching heaven, changing earth,
oh, touching heaven, changing earth, touching heaven, changing earth.
Never looking back, we'll run. Giving you our lives to gain the prize. We will take the harvest given us. Though we sow in tears, we'll reap in joy.
Praise. Lifting up the name of the Lord
in power. We will seek your face, Almighty God. Turn and pray for you to heal our land. Father, let revival start in us. And every heart will know your kingdom come.
Oh,
lifting up the name.
Touching heaven, changing earth, touching heaven, changing earth, touching heaven, changing earth. Send revival, Lord.
Send revival.
Bible to us. touching heaven, changing earth. Oh, we're touching heaven, changing earth. Oh, touching heaven, changing earth. Oh, touching heaven, changing earth. Lord, it's our cry. Oh, touching heaven. Thy kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven, O Lord. O God, there is such love, such joy, such righteousness that we bring, O Lord, to earth. Precious, precious virtues of Christ. Upside down. Lord, we ask for you to be a voice to speak through the mouth of the people. God, that you would arise in the people of this land, in your church, Lord, in the leaders of our nation, all of them, Lord, together to rise up and let your voice be heard. Lord, for the protection of our children. Lord, we just ask you this day, Lord, just shut the mouth of the lion. Lord, prevail, let truth and light and protection prevail for our children in this land, O God. This is our prayer today as mothers, as fathers, as your people, O God. Bring it to pass, O God. Turn this nation, as this song has said, Jesus, turn us, O God.
Lifting up the name of the Lord in power and in unity, we will see our nation. We will see our nation turn. 'Cause we're touching heaven, changing earth. We're gonna change earth, Lord, by touching heaven, changing earth. Touching heaven, oh Jesus. Let this prayer touch your heart today, Lord Jesus. This prayer for our children. This prayer, Lord Jesus.
Lifting up the name of the Lord in power and in unity, we will see our nation turn, touching heaven, changing earth with our prayers. Touching heaven, changing earth.
Hear our cry, Lord, for the children, Lord. Oh, let us take them up in our arms, oh God. Let us rescue them on on every side, Lord. Oh, you're the God of this city, Lord.
Let God, let God.
Rejoice, be glad, for his enemies flee before him. Rejoice,
rejoice,
be glad.
Rejoice, rejoice,
rejoice, be glad.
Let God arise and his enemies be scattered.
Let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Let God arise and his enemies be scattered. Let God,
oh, let God,
let God,
oh, let God,
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 arise, Jesus.
Lord, the scriptures say that in all things, Lord, all things consist in you. Lord, all things are held together by you. All things keep going because of you. And Jesus, that includes our time. That includes our era and our day. God, Lord, and you can come down and step down and arise in our time. God, because you're holding all of this together, God. Lord, everything consists in you, God. Lord Jesus, this morning we acknowledge, God, that it's not, Lord God, that sin is reigning and ruling. It's, God, that we need you to come and hold it together, God, to bring your promises to pass. God, please, you're the key to all of this. You're always the key, God. Please, Jesus, please.
Let God,
let God,
let God,
let God.
You're the God of this city. You're the King of these people. You're the Lord of this nation. You are. You're the light in the darkness. You're the hope to the hopeless. You're the peace to the restless. There is no one like our God. Greater things have yet to come. Greater things are still to be done in this city. Greater things have yet to come. Greater things are still to be done here. Lord, the scriptures say in Revelation that the city is coming out of heaven. Coming down, a four-square city, God. And that's us, your church, a bride adorned for her husband, God. God, you're going to do a great work in your church. Lord, it's going to be a powerful people, God, that a city, a humongous city, will contain your people. Jesus, there is a glorious place you are bringing your church. Jesus, you are the God of this city. You are the God of your church. You dwell in your church. You live in your church. Things flow out of your church. God, oh God, we pray, Lord God, that we would rise to the position you have given your church, Lord, and not bring the church down to our condition. God, but Lord, rise to the position that God has put upon his church, a glorious church, a holy church. God, oh God, arise in your people, God. Please, we pray. You're the God of this city, God. You're the God of this city. And greater things have yet to come for your church. Greater things have yet to come for your people, God. We thank you, Jesus. Greater things have yet to come. Greater things are still to be done in this city. Greater things have yet to come. Greater things are still to be done here. Greater things have yet to come. Greater things are still to be done in this city. Thank you.
shall stand. Lord Jesus, for a city set on a hill cannot be hidden. So those that are in hiding, those that are afraid, come forth. Come forth to the light.
We thank you this morning for our mothers here. God, we lift up our church, Jesus, to you, Jesus. We pray for those that are in other states, God, that are in, have a physical problem. God, we ask, we pray, we lift them up right now, God. We ask that your healing power would come and touch them. Lord Jesus, we pray that that river of life that flows from your throne, that would touch them, Jesus. Lord God, that would move upon their spirit, God, heal them of their body, and Lord, come and give them a new heart, a new mind, and everything that you do with your river of life, God. God, we pray that your river would come to this church here, that it would come to our hearts and our minds, and God, Lord, fill us up, and Lord, go out of us. Jesus, Jesus, we pray for your powerful, powerful word and your spirit in us that comes directly from heaven in its purest form. The pure river, not tainted by our own understanding, not tainted by the world, but Lord, your pure word, your pure love, your pure truth, your pure power. Jesus, please, we pray for your river this morning. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. It's good to be in God's house this morning. Last week we talked about the bride, where God is taking us. The bride, we learned last week, was a bride that worships. And we're reminded of what we do in the service, prophesy, bring a teaching. We have an interpretation, have a tongue of sorts. We are a great multitude in the Bible. It says that in that day there's going to be a number that cannot be numbered. We've got to remember this promise that God is promising. No matter how bleak things look today, when we arrive, it's going to be completely different. There is a glorious church that God is bringing his people to. He has washed us. We are a righteous people. We're called to follow and come to Christ himself. He is inviting us to dwell with him. And our position is higher than our condition. No matter what age or era you live in, we want our condition to rise to the position. I've got a sound issue. Give me just a moment. Ooh. Testing, 1, 2, 3. Testing. Okay, let's see if that helps. Oh. Check, 1, 2. Well. Testing, 1, 2, 3, testing. All right. Revelations 21, I hope that's worse. Revelations 21, 2. I, John, saw the holy city, Jerusalem, coming out of heaven from God, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. This song, You Are God of the City, is very powerful. It's not just talking about Elsinore, it's talking about the church. Yes. Greater things he's going to do in his church. We are that four square city coming out of heaven. And we're prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. That is the church, the bride. The tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people. God himself will be with them and be their God. This is a fulfillment of the new covenant. In Ezekiel, it says that he will be their God. They will be his people. Amen? So God is true to his word here. He's true to his word today, and he will keep true to his word when we are in heaven with him. We're not going to a place where he is not there. He is there. He is right in the center of it all. Revelations 21:4. Every tear he will wipe away from their eyes. There will be no more death, sorrow, no more crying, no more pain. For the former things have passed away. The former battle, having to battle with sin and darkness, that's all gone. No more unholy, unrighteous government. No more corruption. No more sin and Satan's influence. No more persecution. No more of the enemy winning. At least, I hope so. Amen? I will give the fountain of the water of life freely to him who thirsts, and he who overcomes shall inherit all things. And here's the key. Very important word right there. He who what? Overcomes. Gosh, I wish I could just say, oh, you know, we can just meld right into whatever the era of Christianity is today. To me, I can't. I read that, I read these scriptures, I say to myself, I can't go along with it. I can't just conform. You know, your heart, you read something like this and your heart just says, no. I got to overcome. Why? Because I want to inherit these things. He said, I will be his God, he shall be my son. I want to inherit my inheritance from God. And because I want to inherit, I'm going to overcome. If you remember Revelation chapter 3, he says seven times, he who overcomes, and he tells them, he gives them seven rewards and seven things he talked about. So I'm not just only going to give it a new name. I get to have a seat at the throne of God. I get to have the tree of life. Everything that is promised in Revelation chapter 3, I get to inherit all those things. And you know what? Well, I might be just happy just sitting at his throne. Well, and the tree of life. I want to keep living. Don't you want to inherit all those things in heaven? We've got to stick to the truth. We've got to stick to what Christ says, regardless of what people say, regardless of what the influence is or the pressure is in this world. Revelations 21, verse 8, the cowardly, fearful, unbelieving, abominable, murderers, sexually immoral, sorcerers, idolaters, all liars shall have their part in the lake of fire, which is the second death. I don't want that. And the first thing it says, the cowardly. Oh my gosh, that hit me. Am I a coward? Gosh. Am I so fearful that I'm going to give in? It's powerful. I don't want to be a coward. I don't want to be fearful. The abominable, those that are living a life that is detestable, they're headed to a lake of fire. Whether or not America comes up with all kinds of remedies and things for their life, they're headed to a lake of fire. The sexually immoral, murderers, sorcerers, idolaters, liars. It's so important what comes out of our mouth. I don't want to be a coward. And then an angel comes in to John in Revelation 21, verse 9, and he has one of the bowls in his hands with the last plagues, and there's seven angels, and he's one of them. And I'm sure this is not how it happened, but he's standing there, and he's like, man, I got to tell John something. Look at this stuff over here. He's got a bowl in his hand. He's got ADHD, okay? He's got hyperactive disorder. His attention is not on what's going on in his hands. He's got a bowl with the last plague, and he's saying, hey, let me get rid of this thing. John, come. I want to show you something. Now, normally when we think of the angel, we think, John, come with me, walking slowly. But I imagine it this way. I want to show you the bride. He's excited. Heaven is excited about the church. Amen? Heaven is excited about God's people. Heaven is excited about that city coming down. It's going to be beautiful. And we can have that beauty in us today. Just because it's going to be visibly and amazing in heaven doesn't mean we can't have the results and the power of it in us today. And the angel showed me the great city descending out of heaven, having the glory of God. Her light was like a most precious stone. Her light was like a most precious stone. So the church has the light shining in them. Matthew 5:14, you are the light of the world, talking to his people, his church, his disciples. Are we shining? Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works, he goes on to say. And so we see pretty simply that God is very consistent with his message. The church is a holy city, and it's going to be shining like a precious stone. Why is it shining? Because they are the light of the world. Why are they the light of the world? Because they did what was right. John 3:19, this is the condemnation, that light has come into the world, but men love darkness rather than light. For everyone practicing evil hates the light and does not come to the light. So when we practice evil, we hate the light. When we are not practicing evil, we reject evil, which is called the fear of the Lord. When we have the fear of God and we follow and do what's right, we are projecting the light of Christ. So the scriptures give us a good definition of what it means to shine. It's not necessarily about money or rich or how rich you are. When you go to other countries, there can be poor people that are letting their light shine. Why? Because they refuse to capitulate and give in. They will stand on truth and follow truth, no matter how much money they have, no matter how bad their situation is, no matter what's going on in their third world country. They don't have freedoms and all this, but they will follow Christ and do what's right. That is the light that shines. Revelation 21:14. Hey, give a size to this city, and I just wanted to bring it up because it's really large. It's a 1,500 mile cube. So that's from here to Dallas, Texas, is about 1,500 miles, a little less than 1,500 miles. And I've driven to Dallas, Texas, and it's far. And not only the cube is... It's not just long, it's that wide, and it's also that high. So it's humongous, this city. And, who knows what it's going to be like. It really doesn't matter. Okay? What matters is going to be glorious. It's going to be beautiful. I don't know if it's going to be all city inside of it or on the outside of it, like the, how the earth is. You know, who cares? You know, we'll get all the information there.
There's gardens on the outside.
Mrs. Daigle said, there's gardens? There's gardens on the outside. Oh, that's funny. Don't get fixated on, you know, how big, how is that, what's the measure and how big, you know, it's going to be amazing. It's going to be awesome and beautiful. But the point is that God is there. He's dwelling in it. And God can do that today in us. Remember what Jesus prayed before he was crucified. He says that they might know me. I am eternal life. And we can have the eternal life before we die. We can be part of this city before we die. Amen. John 14:2, in my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you. And my message is to those who have a lot of possessions and are rich. This question is to those. You may be rich on earth today. You may have so many things that you don't even know what you have. You know, you go home and you look in your garage. You don't even look at all the stuff, right? Or maybe you have another building out there. You can't remember all the things that you have. Or maybe you own so many properties. You have to have a spreadsheet to have them all listed on there. Who knows? But do you have eternal real estate in heaven? You may have all the things that you could ever want in this life, but have nothing and no claim in heaven. And that is a tragedy. Revelation 21:22, I saw no temple in it, for the Lord God Almighty and the Lamb are its temple. And we bring this up and I point this out because in this place, there's no need for an illustration anymore of a temple. There's no need for a building. There's no need for a place. Or, this is what it is. No, this is the actual thing. This is the real thing. Here it is. So we got to focus on a temple or a building being built or some beautiful, billions of dollars invested in something. That's not where it's at. The city is the bride. It is the house. It is the temple of God. We are the real thing. 1 Peter 2:4, coming to him as to a living stone rejected by men, chosen by God and precious, you are living stones being built up a spiritual house, a holy priesthood to offer up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God through Jesus Christ. It says you might be rejected by men. Oh my goodness. That's tough. But chosen by God. I'd rather be chosen by God than chosen by the world. Accepted by God than accepted by the world. You're being built up a spiritual house. In this case, a spiritual city. A holy priesthood offering up spiritual sacrifices acceptable to God. I will give myself to you a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable unto God. We offer ourselves a living sacrifice, holy and acceptable. We sacrifice all the pleasures that this world could offer, and we're not focusing on that. Not that we can't partake of anything in this world, but you know, we sacrifice our time. We sacrifice what our wants are, and we say God is first. The city had no need of the sun or the moon, for the glory of God illuminated it. The Lamb is its light. We are the light of the world when we have Christ inside of us. So here, Christ is in the city. The city is shining like a precious stone, but now Christ is in it. And its light, his light, is so vast. You know, you think about the difference between the moon and the sun. The sun is the actual light. You look outside and it's bright. You can actually see things and color and all of that. At nighttime, that moon shines and it's kind of like, oh, that's pretty. It's beautiful, but it's a big difference. There's a big difference. The Lamb is its light. The Lord God Almighty, the Lamb, are in the temple. They give life, they give energy. Verse 24, the nations of those who are saved shall walk in its light. There shall be no night there, and they shall bring the glory of God, the glory and the honor of the nations into it. Jesus said, out of every kindred, tongue, and tribe, I will bring a people unto myself. You see, there's no difference here. There's no race here. There's one people. He's bringing out of every kindred, every tribe, a people unto himself to walk in its light. They're going to follow the light of Jesus Christ. Revelations 21, 27. There will by no means enter it anything that defiles and causes abomination or causes an abomination or a lie, but only those who are written in the Lamb's book of life. It's so important. The standard is going to be there. God can't look at the world today and just say, oh, well, you know, this is 2023, so we're going to use 2023 rules. The rules have changed. No. This is where we're headed. This is not years ago. He's talking about the future. The future is that he's not going to allow anything in that defiles. He's not going to allow things that are an abomination or a lie, but only those who are written in the Lamb's book of life. You can't just go and get a certificate from a church that says, I've been baptized. Oh, that's great, you've been baptized. But are you living a flagrant, sinful life? You won't be able to get in to this holy, beautiful city. If you haven't repented, if you haven't renounced your sins, been born again, and changing them, you're not in that book of life. We need our names written in the book of life. It is important that we don't come to change the church to meet the condition we are at. And that is where we are at today. People come in, and because of American capitalism, they think that it's just like another business. Oh, well, I'm going to review that place. It's not what I like. That's not the flavors I like. That's not the things I like. So I'm not going to go there. I'm going to put them down and talk them down. And I'm going to go to another church. Oh, I like this. I like that. I need this cooked a little better. You know, that's how we handle stuff, because that's how we're conditioned to think. Okay, everybody's competing for my business. No, that's not what the church is. That is not what that holy city is. The holy city is not competing for your business. Do you want to get into that holy city? If you do, you have got to compete to get in there. Paul said, I ran my race. I fought the good fight. Are you fighting and competing with the kingdom of darkness to get in that holy city? They're not going to be separate rooms for the different denominations. You know, welcome, church. Oh, wait, you're Presbyterian. Go over here, this section over here. Oh, wait, Catholic? Oh, over here. Oh, wait, you're... There's one city with God's people, the bride adorned. It doesn't say that we're all different and we're all different, but we're not segregated here. We're not separated. We're one church. Revelation 22, verse 1. He showed me a pure river of water of life, clear as crystal, proceeding from the throne of God and of the Lamb. In the middle of its street, on either side, was the tree of life, which bore 12 fruits, and the leaves of the tree were for the healing of the nations. And we already learned that the Lamb and the Lord God Almighty are in this city. And so when it says the throne, from the throne of God and from the Lamb, this river is coming out of the city, out of that holy bride. A pure river of water of life. And that is what our country needs. That is what all nations need. They need the pure river of life. That healing that is falling from the trees. The healing that is falling from the tree of life. Just the trees are giving healing. How much more will the fruit be beneficial to your life? Way above medication, way above psychology or inspirational quotes, people need to touch the river of life that flows from directly from God. And we, as a church, have a responsibility to seek God, to fast and pray until He brings that river. We have a responsibility to find that powerful river of God. A lot of churches and pastors right now are really concerned about our time and our era. They're concerned about the next generation. And we are concerned too. Amen? And we can go a lot of routes and look for a lot of solutions, but this river of life better be part of it. Amen? This river of life that is powerful, that has healing, that has the tree of life, we have to have that number one. Because that's where God is taking His church. That's where He's bringing us. To a place where the river of God is flowing out of us. That's what we need. And I'm up here and I don't know myself what and how, but I know that we need this above everything else. People need to drink from that river. Amen. So we're going to sing this song. We had a short message today, but very important on how important the bride is. Amen. We need to be born again. Don't you want to be a citizen of that holy city? Don't you want the results of that holy city now? Amen. We don't want to bring down the holy city to our condition. The holy city is something to reach for. It's something to guide your life, to head toward, to grow into. We need to pray that our condition would rise to that, the position of that holy city, the bride, coming out of heaven. And we want to partake of that river, that pure river that flows from His throne. And the tree of life. So right now, let's take a few moments just to sing and invite Christ, invite that pure river right now.
Let your living water come flow over my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control. Every situation that has troubled my mind, all my cares and burdens unto you I roll. Let your living water flow over my soul. Let your Holy Spirit come and take control of
to be with her. And Lord, they were fine. And Peter didn't carry that load, didn't carry that burden. He was free. And Jesus, your blood and your water that poured from your side was sufficient for every generation to come. Every generation passed, and that blood and water still flows. The blood that cleanses us from all sin, and that water that washes, that water that replenishes life in us. And Lord, we have that same power in us, that we can trust you with our children. We can trust you with our families, Lord. And Lord, from this house, we can go out and we can reach people, Lord, because we know, Lord, that you'll take care of our lands, you'll take care of our houses, our children, our families. Lord, even as the Israelites in that example you gave us, Lord, they had to leave everything to go and gather for those special times. And Lord, they didn't worry about people coming and raiding and destroying their lands. They put their trust in you. And Lord, I pray that we will put our trust in you, that we are free to reach out and to touch lives and to see your kingdom come on earth as it is in heaven this day, Jesus. Thank you, Lord.
We're going to lift up our... We're going to pray for healing right now. We've got some folks in other states right now that are in the hospital. We have people that are healing from different problems, and we're going to lift them up right now and ask God to heal, do a work in their lives. Let his powerful river flow in them. Let's lift up our voices. Lord God, we come before you this morning. Jesus, Jesus, we pray. Lord God, you, Lord Jesus, would use this an opportunity, God, to heal. Lord, to show this next generation that you are powerful, God. Lord, he heals, Lord, peoples, Lord, situations, God, Lord, we lift them up, Lord. God, it's not by mankind, Lord, you're the one who heals, Jesus. Lord, but we ask, we plead, and we pray, Lord, we summon you, God, to come. Come to your mighty throne, Lord Jesus. Come to Curtis Life, God, Lord, where she's at in the hospital, Jesus. Lord, we lift her up in prayer, God, and pray for my Father, God, Jesus, to touch her, Jesus, please, Jesus, Lord, we lift them up in prayer right now, God. We also pray for the next generation, Lord, God, you show the world, God, how great you were, Lord, by your miracles, your mighty power, God. We need that today. And they are held together. God, in you all things are restored. Jesus, you're the key, you're the answer. God, oh God, Lord, you are the healing power, God. Jesus, Jesus, mighty God. Jesus, King of kings. Lord, Lord God Almighty, God, pour out your river of life. Pour out your river of life, God. Jesus, not just a spiritual experience where we can say, oh, how wonderful, but Lord, a river of life that, Lord, transforms what once was dead, Lord, what once was going to the lake of fire, Lord, but is brought to life again. Jesus, Jesus, please, we pray for that pure river, God, please. Lord, let it flow. God, let it touch. Lord, let it touch this world. Open up. Lord, open up the dam that holds back the water. God, open up the spout, Jesus. Jesus, please, we pray, God. Oh, let your river pour out. Your river of life, your river of truth, your river of power, God. Lord, let your influence come. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Please, oh Lord. mic to Mr. Thompson so he can pray in closing.
Jesus, this day we cast all of our burdens and cares upon you. Like your word says, to learn of you. Learn of your meekness. Learn of your kindness. Learn of what you did when you came to this earth, Jesus. That is your son said, Father, that the will and purpose of his life, the food of his life, was to accomplish the work that he was sent to do. And this day we ask you, Father, by your son and by your spirit, Lord, let us be those that do the will of you, Father, by your son, by your spirit. That we be a people, Lord, whole and complete like you. To learn of you, Jesus Christ. That by we can enter into your rest, Lord. Letting you labor, letting you work in our lives. To be a sure house, built up and established by you. Whole and complete, perfect and entire, lacking no good thing. By walking uprightly, Lord, by doing what's right. Let us be a people, Lord, and see that work of you, the river of your word and your spirit flowing in and out of our lives, Jesus. That river of your word and your spirit, let it come, work in us and out of us, Lord. Like your word says, pour from vessel to vessel. There will be no end to that river in our life and out of our life to others. As a church, as natural and spiritual families, Lord, as individuals, Lord, come and do that complete work. And like your word says, cut it short in righteousness, Jesus. To be a people that know what to do, how to do it, and when to do it, Jesus. As you did when you walked this earth, Jesus. Made like you, Lord, awake. And satisfy with only your express image and likeness in our lives. That's our goal. That's our purpose, Lord. Be conformed to your express image. Not a carbon copy, but your express image and likeness, Lord. To awake to righteousness. Awaken us, Lord. Make us whole and complete like you. We ask it because you desire it. And that is the will of your Father. In your will. Amen.
Spirit, God, and we pray, Lord Jesus. Lord, in these coming weeks and these coming days and these coming months, God, that we would seek for that river of life, that it would come in this church, that it would come into us as individuals, God, and that we would pour it out of us into this city, into this community, and to our world, Jesus. In your precious name. Everyone said, amen. Right now, I'd like one of the gentlemen, if we could hand out a flower pot to the mothers. And wish you guys a happy Mother's Day. Those online, we want to thank you for joining us. We trust this morning that you want your condition to rise to the position that God has called you. That holy city coming out of heaven, adorned as a bride for her husband. Powerful, powerful church. trust this morning you heard God's word. God bless you today. Happy Mother's Day, all you mothers. God bless you. Amen.